when Jim made known that he'd like for me to preach a little bit, there was a certain place the Lord, actually a lot of what Jim preached on this morning came to my mind real fresh. Maybe he didn't press it enough. But anyway, I think he done a wonderful job this morning. I really do. And anyway, we remember Jesus saying one time that men should pray and not faint. Because whenever I read of what the Lord spoke of is coming to pass, I'm telling you that it's something to think about. Jim preached this morning, and I'm going to go over part of it, that the Lord would come with all of his saints. I don't know how many saints they are, but I know it's in the millions. Millions of saints around about the throne was praising God, and Christ shall come with all of those angels. On the clouds of glory he'll come. And he shall execute judgment upon the world, and them that's not ready, it'll be too late to get ready. And so then we see, one time I remember the Lord, he got together with certain two sisters. They had a brother, and that brother had got sick and he died. And they sent to the Lord and said, "He whom thou lovest is sick." And the Lord told the disciples, "We'll go into Judea again." But the disciples said, "Lord, those that the Jews of late thirst, they sought to stone thee. And would you go there again?" But the Lord, whenever he makes his mind up, that's it. And so we find the Lord, whenever he was headed toward the house of Martha and Mary, they lived not quite 2 miles from Jerusalem. And we find that Martha heard about the Lord coming. So she went out to see the Lord. She didn't say a thing to Mary about it. She slipped out and went toward where the Lord was. When she got there, she knelt before the Lord, no doubt, and she said, "Lord, if you'd have been here, my brother wouldn't have died." And so the Lord said, "Thy brother shall raise again." Amen. And she said, "Lord, I know he'll raise again in the resurrection at the last day." And the Lord said to her, ask her if she believed, in other words. And she said that she did believe in him, that he was the Son of God. "Lord, I believe that you're the Christ," she said, "that should come into the world." And she told him that. And so then the Lord had never yet made his way completely to where they lived. And so Martha went back, and she no doubt whispered in the ear of Mary and said, "The Master wants to see you. Listen to me. My friend, it's a welcome thing for every child of God that's living right. I thank God for the Lord to say, I want to talk to you. I want to have a talk with you. There's nothing like that. Anyway, and she told Mary, of the Lord. The Master wants to talk to you. And she got up real quick and went toward where he was. And so many of the Jews that had gathered there, they thought that Mary had got up to go where that their brother had died. They thought that she was going there, my friend, and to weep for him, and they followed her. But anyway, Mary, I got to the Lord, and when she got there, the Bible said that she knelt right there before him, and she said, "Lord, same thing that Martha did. Lord, if you'd have been here, my brother would not have died. But I know now Martha had done told the Lord, I know whatsoever that you will ask of God, God will give it to you." Mary comes along of the same line and says, "If you'd have been here, my brother would not have died." And so the Lord told the disciples, we're going into this place again, where the Jews of late sought to stone him, and the disciples tried to persuade him different. But thank God, when Jesus makes his mind up, it's made up, and he's made it up. Nobody can get to heaven any other way except through and by Jesus. There's no other way. And so Jesus, my friend, I want you to know, he headed toward where they lived. And my friend, when he got there, he said, "Where have you laid him?" Listen, Martha said, "Lord, by this time, he stinketh. He's been dead 4 days already." But the Lord said, "Martha, I said not unto thee that if you would believe, you could see the resurrection or the glory of God." And she said to the Lord, my friend, after he'd said that, the Lord, the disciples was there, and they was Jews there. They was watching him. And Jesus said, as I said a while ago, where have you laid him? And so they finally showed him. And Jesus, thank God, he went over to the side, no doubt. Anyway, he looked up to God in heaven. He knew that God heard him always. And he said, "Father, I know that you've heard me. Thank God, I know God's heard me too. I know that I'm not anything big anymore. I've got old. I'm my friend and can't do like I want to for God. But listen to me." The Lord looked up and said, "Father, I thank you that you've heard me and that you hear me always. I knew it." And he said, "But because of the people that stand by," he said, "I said it that they may believe that thou hast sent me." Brother, the main thing in serving God I used to believe in Jesus. There's no other way. I remember one time when some of the disciples They wanted to know what is. How do you serve God? Jesus said, I believe on him whom God has sent. He said, this is serving God. Words to that effect. Listen to me. And so Jesus, my friend, when he said this, he said, take away the stone. That was when Martha said, but this time, Lord, he stinketh. He's been dead 4 days already. But he said, Martha, said not I unto thee, if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God. And so when they rolled the stone away, Jesus lifted his voice up, and he said, Lazarus, come forth. And Lazarus began to breathe. Thank God he began to move. And he got up. And he began to walk forward. And he was clothed in grave clothes, hand and foot. And there was a napkin about him. And the Lord said, loose him and let him go. I remember the time, brother, that I was saved, 1948, whenever I looked up to God, I had to pray several days and nights. It wasn't God's fault. It was my fault. But I wanted to make sure. I remember Johnny Bright, his mother, she came and tried to get me to have faith. But, brother, I wanted something that I knowed about. I wanted to know the Lord. And so I looked up the night that I started to stay home. Listen, God spoke to me. And he said, son, go tonight. And I went. That was about the fourth or the fifth night. And I went. We had to, like we go into the door of the church, back there next to the door to get out was the pulpit. And if you got out, you had to go by the preacher. I remember Johnny, whenever he preached, it seemed like he was looking straight at me. It seemed like somebody had told him everything that I'd done. But it was God, brother, that was telling me that I need to repent. And so I went back right in the corner where Mike is and the pulpit stand. I was over here in front of the exit door. I went over there and I looked up and I said, Father, I've done all I know to do. You know what I had to do? I had to give up gambling. I'd have made a gambler if I hadn't to give it up. And I had to give that up. And I looked up and I said, God, now I've done all I know to do. I've give up gambling. I used to go in to the beer joint where they had machines in there. I'd hit the jackpot and I'd turn around and put it all back in. But the Lord wanted me to quit that, and I did. And I said, God, now I've done all I know to do. And when I said that, brother, there was a power that lifted me up on my feet And there was a whole bunch of young people. I was young then. And there was a whole bunch of them praising the Lord. You know what I done? I joined in with them in praising the Lord. And I went home that night and I said, Mother, I got saved tonight. I thank God she was already a Christian. I want to say, my friend, that Jesus Christ is coming with all the angels. It looks to me like that it's just about time, Lord, for you to come because they've encamped around the church until they're trying to shut us out. But I tell you one thing, they can't keep us from worshiping God. They can't keep us from doing the will of God. And so I say to you, Jesus said that men should pray and not faint. I've prayed a little after that. God called me to preach. I didn't guess about it. I knew it was coming from God. I'd go down to the river and I'd fish a little bit. I didn't like it. My heart was on preaching for the Lord. And so for 60 years or over, I preached for the Lord. He preached me. I couldn't preach myself, but he preached me. Thank God. I've seen a many of people, brother in revivals, where I preach. It wasn't me that saved them. I didn't save anybody. But thank God, I've seen a many a revival that I preach for the people would be saved. And brother, I felt good in the Lord, and I feel that everything's all right tonight with me and God. And so I come to you asking you to pray for me because I want to do more than anything else the will of God. I want to preach for him. My friend, even in my old age, I want to preach for God. Listen to me. Jim here, I preached a wonderful message this morning. And so I say to you, do what he says to do. The Lord said that if he was feeding his people, words to that effect, that he would I bless you and make you able to stand. Jim, I know without a doubt that you're in earnest what you're saying and that you was moved by the Lord to preach like you did. And so I say to you, brother, that Christ is coming with all of his angels. And he'll send them forth over the earth. And Jesus will call for all of them that's in the graves. Come forth. They that have done good will come forth to a resurrection of life. And they that have done evil will come forth to a resurrection of damnation. So we thank you for your prayers tonight. And there's one thing about it. There's nobody can keep me from living right. Nobody. There's nobody can keep me from praying. There's nobody can keep me from living for the Lord. And so I look up every day, my friend, to God in heaven. And he hears me too. Yeah, he hears me. And so I look up and he looks down. That time I got saved, I looked up. God had to look down because I was way down. And I got saved and I've been saved ever since. And I ain't got no desire for anything that's a sin. I don't have any desire. And I thank God for that. There's a lot of people that may have a desire to go back on the Lord. But brother, you're in bad shape if you do. Hold fast to God's unchanging hand. The Lord said man ought to pray and not to perish, but he ought to pray. One scripture these points to that. And so I say unto you, it looks to me like that the way what's going on over here across the water, if something ain't done, it looks to me like they're going to be over here. If they do, they'll not have no mercy on us. That's all right. Jesus will take care of us. I need your prayers that I may always find the will of God being done in my life. And I'll pray for you. God bless you.